Hello, I'm Fala again. Today we are going to be wiping the floors with aliens. Hey, hi, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of XCOM Long War Build Showcase. Today we are going to be talking about Crit Scout. This is, I also like to call him Flanker Scout. This is the kind of scout that you get if you want to be able to deal some critical and important damage from the enemy flank or uncovered position. And quite frankly, it also may be used as a mop-up crew, and it's a very effective, however, rarely used unit, and it has some serious underappreciation, in my opinion. This unit can seriously deal some serious damage to an enemy as long as you can get him to a flank. So, your main important stat is, of course, mobility, and secondary is aim. You want both of those to be high, because you need the soldier to a flank, and he is going to be mopping up everything, and that's why he has to hit that, you know. And, yeah, let's talk perks. We are taking Lone Wolf on Lance Corporal because this unit will very often be jumping from our formation to the open space so that he can take shots and then return to safety, and he will be most likely more than 7 tiles away from your formation, so the additional aim and critical chance is going to be very useful for you whichever way we are going to be taking later on. Next on, we have two choices. If we are going to be going the hit and run way, then we are going to be taking Ranger. If you want to take the in the zone way, then Deadeye is more important for you to mop up everything remaining. However, Ranger can also be very useful, of course. And hence we are taking Ranger because it's important for both the options we have in this build. Because the Ranger gives you plus one damage to primary weapons, which is fucking important, and works with vital point targeting, so this is very good. And Deadeye just makes it easier for you to hit the flying target, which is completely useless with hit and run. However, you can use it within the zone to clean up floaters and drones. Next on, since we are working for critical damage, we want aggression because plus 10 critical chance per enemy inside, max 30%, is hugely important for you. We are going to be mopping up enemies left and right with that, so you need aggression for either way. And as you notice, we are not taking battle scanner for this unit. We are going to be talking about the equipment later. Now for the most important thing. On Tech Sergeant, you have a very important choice that is going to define the build. If you take hit and run, then this unit is going to be either taking out enemies that have been uncovered by explosives earlier with very accurate and very deadly critical shots with marksman rifle, or if you take in the zone, you are going to be using that unit as a sort of in the zone sniper to clean up damaged enemies that have been uncovered by explosives. However, both are very important for you because they allow you to shoot and then retreat. In the zone allows you to shoot and then retreat as long as you kill your enemies with every single shot. If it doesn't work, then you're going to be stranded in the open most of the time, and the hit and run allows you to take a shot at an uncovered enemy and then take another shot or retreat, because your first shot against an uncovered or flanked target does not cost an action, but remember a very important caveat: it does not work against flying units, which means that if you take Deadeye within the zone, then you made a little bit of a mistake, and well, you can't change it, so I feel a little bit sorry for you. Which is why I'm warning you that do not take hit and run if you have to, if you are planning on taking down flying floaters. In this case, in the zone is better for you. However, if you are intending to shoot twice and deal a huge amount of damage or hit and then run back into cover, then hit and run is the perk for you. I'm going to take it, however, remember that in the zone is equally as important. I just had to pick something, right? And next on, we are taking Bring-Em-On that confers critical damage on critical hits, which is very critical for you to deal that critical damage on critical hits, because, you know, if not, your mission can change into a critical failure. So yeah, moving on. Vital point targeting works very well with Ranger, giving you altogether plus 3 damage on your main weapon, which is very important for you. Because it will allow you to deal more critical damage and kill your enemies more effectively, and then you can I mean, you can concern yourself most with hit rather than run part of the build, and it allows you to basically create your scout as your flanking killing machine that can ignore overwatches, get in the open, take shots, kick ass and chew bubblegum, and remember there is no such small item as bubblegum. So we are taking vital point targeting, remember that it confers plus 2 damage against humans and aliens that you have already autopsied. And yeah, that is as far as the perk goes. Now, let's talk armors. You want armors that are going to give you mobility. So grappling hook armors and all kinds of armors that are giving you also defense and mobility are good for you, archangels and so on. As for weapons, well, you are going to be working either with a shotgun or a marksman rifle. I had the right to use this build with a normal rifle class, but the damage is just unsatisfying. And I suggest strongly to either focus on shotguns or marksman rifle with the marksman scope. And especially I would recommend a marksman rifle with a marksman scope for the in the zone, because it will allow you to mop up your enemies from afar without them even seeing you. You can just get to a flank that is completely beyond their line of sight, and they won't even be able to react. If they try to react to your unit flanking them, then they would just uncover themselves for all the rest of your squad and get fucked. And similarly, it is working with hit and run. However, with hit and run, I have had some more success with the normal rifle than with the marksman rifle. Of course, both of the options, either in the zone or hit and run, work very well with a shotgun. And believe me, there is nothing more satisfying than mopping up a whole squad of mutants with a shotgun up close. That's just so lovely. Good days. In any way, so much for the gear. Of course, as your small items, you want to take anything that gives you the bonus critical damage and bonus base damage for your weapons. And bonus critical chance, that's very important for you as well. Now, let's talk gene mods. Gene mods that you will want to take for this soldier is smart macrophages, may be useful for you, because teen mints are going to love to spit on that unit for some reason, though I don't really see why, since it's just a class cannon in DPS. And you may want to take hyperreactive pupils for both hit and run and in the zone. However, it's going to be working best with hit and run. If you miss your first shot, then you can take another one with plus 10 aim. It's going to be very good for you. And you may take Adrenal Neurosympathy, because this is going to be the first unit that is very likely to break enemy overwatches and kill somebody, thus boosting your whole squad to finish off whatever is remaining. And that is going to be a very beneficial for you in the long run. Bioelectric Skin, this is a flanking unit, so Bioelectric Skin, as usual, is going to allow you to, you know, enter the fog of war without worrying that you will inadvertently make your situation worse by activating additional enemies, right? Bioelectric Skin will allow you to simply avoid that kind of stupid situations that are stupid, unnecessary and hurtful for everybody. And you may take, if you want, of course, either Muscle Fiber Density or Adaptive Bone Marrow. It is totally unimportant for the build, unless, of course, the Jumpy Legs will give you the option to use your Marksman Rifle and in the zone or hit and run from a rooftop, which is great, and then I also advise you take Depth Perception. Now, if that unit has a good or decent wheel, then you can use it as your active psionic very efficiently if it doesn't have an opportunity to get out of for a flanking formation. And yeah, you can just get yourself a mind fray and distortion fields and so on, so that while the scout remains with the team and doesn't have the opportunity to for a good flank, he is still useful for you. Then of course you can grab yourself the mind fray and the distortion field, psy panic or mind merge, and telekinetic field to provide defense for your squad. Or you can go a more selfish way and just give him neural feedback if his will is bad, so that he doesn't have to worry about stuff and shit and just go and do his job. But that's the neural dampening gene mod, I'm sorry. And you can also go into more selfish psionic route with Regen Biofield. And, well, Psy Inspiration would be good for your tier 2 in this case, because while it doesn't actually give you anything, it is better than Distortion Field for you. And then just get yourself a Psy Panic, so you can protect yourself when you are caught in the open in a flank. It's also very important for you. However, this is not really a psionically up the build. You can give him psionic abilities if you want to, of course, as just as for everyone else, but this is not going to create you any efficient synergies, since this unit very much bases on being alone in the field and kicking ass seriously. So psionics are not going to be the thing you will use most often, unless they are passive abilities, while you can't go for a flank, or while you don't have ammunition and time to reload, I guess, because you will be shooting every single time you can, since this is your typical glass cannon unit that is also good at eating overwatches, so it can go for a nice flanks and then come back. So yeah, that's it about the crit scout. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, let me know in the comments, like the video, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and I will see you again in the next episode of Build Showcases. Bye bye, thanks for watching.